So this morning we talked, in your presentation this morning, you talked about the need for a strong statewide organization. Why do you believe that that is an important factor in the equation?
Well, you know, we have quite a bit of experience now in winning domestic partnerships, civil unions, marriage in a number of states. And I can tell you that every single time we have been successful, a critical, absolutely necessary part of that equation has been having a strong, active, statewide LGBT advocacy group that can advocate for us in the legislature and that absolutely needs to be a partner in any litigation going forward. When we won marriage equality in California, we had Equality California as a plaintiff in the case. And at every possible turn, we were coordinating so closely to make sure that the legal effort was in sync with legislative efforts. Equality California was actually, during the 4 years that case took, able to pass a number of statutes with legislative findings that we would then use in the court case itself. We did joint research on what are the best messages to reach the public, and we used those same themes and messages in our briefs to the court. I mean, it was the most tightly coordinated partnership you can imagine, and that is why we were successful. That was also true in Massachusetts, that was true in Connecticut, it was true in Iowa. Those state groups have to be strong, stable, and they have to be working closely with the people who are doing the actual, in the legislature, doing the lobbying and advocacy, and any kind of litigation effort that's going forward. The state group has to be a part of that.
Why is it important to pass all types of statutes that don't equate to marriage equality? Why is that important to pass those sorts of statutes in the legislature?
You know, our goal, the goal of all the statewide groups is to provide full protections for our families so that we can be authentically ourselves in every aspect of our lives. So we need to be passing anti-discrimination statutes, which you guys have in New Mexico, at least in the main areas. And we need to pass statutes that protect our families, that protect parenting rights, and that recognize our relationships. We need those substantive protections, and we absolutely need to lay a foundation of those kind of statutory protections in order to get full equality, in order to get marriage rights. You can't just go from 0 to 60 or 0 to 100, whatever, with getting full marriage equality without some sort of legislative foundation. We need to get those legislators educated about our families, used to passing laws that protect us, and then we use all of those statutes in court cases to show the courts that, hey, this is the public policy of this state. These are families that have been recognized by the legislature. Our state acknowledges that we need to treat these families equally. So we're asking you, court, to just take that final step and hold it, yes, you have to provide full equality, but that is much easier to do when you have something to build upon than when you're asking the court to do all of the work all by itself. That's a much harder sell to any court.
In your estimation, would you describe how you see New Mexico situated among the other, the 44 states?
New Mexico is such an important state now because you're one of the few states left that does not have either a constitutional or a statutory DOMA. That's incredibly important. You are in the spotlight now in terms of sort of next on the block here to hopefully first make the push to domestic partnership and then as quickly as possible achieve marriage equality. We really need another state in this part of the country in the Southwest. We had California, we lost it temporarily, I hope. We're working really hard to get marriage equality back in California, but we need to start building a regional block out here with California. Nevada now passed comprehensive domestic partnership. We really need New Mexico to keep the momentum going.
What is the first step towards marriage equality in New Mexico?
Well, you guys have already been laying a foundation with working so hard to get a domestic partnership law passed, and those efforts need to just be redoubled and tripled and quadrupled. You know, it's very important to make that final push through if you can to get your domestic partnership law passed. And then a big thing that needs to happen is more public education and even community education to just let people in our community know why marriage equality is so important and to get people used to standing up for themselves and demanding full equality, because it's hard for a lot of us. I mean, many people still are not even comfortable being out in many aspects of their life. You know, we want people to, that's so damaging, and we want people to be able to be fully themselves and be proud of who they are, and to do that, you have to have strong community support, and that's such an important role that Equality New Mexico can play, and really lead the way on that. Just building that strong community then gives us a platform to go and talk to family, friends, co-workers, and legislators. And then that is the goal. In many ways, you know, that's what we want to achieve, a state where people can be open and accepted, and other people see us as human beings and recognize we're families too. We have the same hopes and dreams as everyone else. I mean, imagine living in that kind of a world, and that is where you guys are heading.
Thank you, Shannon.